Hey guys, my name is Gordon, and this is Solomon Kelly Tech Profound, and this is actually really good Tech Profound. I won quite a lot of tools. Well, I drew a lot of tournament because of the continent. Yeah. So, let's get started. And just to know that, I have only one copy of every Solomon Kelly card. So, if you critic my video, just make sure that I'm not that it's okay, and yeah, I know this deck is not the best, but still, it has pretty good cards. So let's get started, and here goes. And now, so the first, there will be groups of high level Solomon Great, level 4 Solomon Great, level 3 Solomon Great, level 2 Solomon Great, and level 1 Solomon Great, and also I'm playing. A lot of non-Solomon Great monsters, just to know that, and also wolf spells, also, and threats, so let's just begin. So for high level monsters, so playing the one low wave Solomon Great EP zone, this card is pretty good, it is pretty handy, when you want to special summon him, and you can use him for the link summon of League 4 monster days, but Solomon Great or something else. Okay, so no. And next is for level 5 Solomon Great panel. This card is here is good, really good, pretty handy if you want to special summon an easy Solomon Great or just treat this card to gain 2000 luck points. It is pretty handy, and yeah. So, and it's a special summon effect, so you can special summon it during your opponent's turn, and that's also one of the coolest effects of a Cyrus monster I've ever seen in action. So, okay, so let's go with the low force summon grid, and they're only 4, they're level, so here they are. I'm playing Jack Jaguar because it's a piece of effect. They are all Solomon Great cards. Are really, really, really impressive with their effect. And his effect, his first effect is good battle damage. His first false effect is special summon itself. Wolf's effect is when you link summon a monster using him. It's not, it's an effect with a effect. Or and it's indestructible for the rest of this turn. And also Falco, because of its precise effect. And his precise effect is to return one Solomon Great spell card, more trap, or mirror graveyard to your hand. So it's pretty handy, but this card is only destroyed, so basically you can't tribute it for anything else. And so there you go. Level 4, moving on to the level 3, I'm playing, just a sec, there you go, I'm playing the 1 Gazelle, because it's effect to special summon itself in your hand, and it's a really good card, I really appreciate it. And next is Foxer, because it's reciting effect to return 1 Solomon Great League monster from the graveyard to the extra deck, and destroy 1 face down spell or trap. Or well activated, so let's say that your opponent has Mirror Force Launcher and he's playing a Mirror Force deck or something else, just continuous, or he has face of course, and when you activate Fox's effect and one monster from your greater to the extra deck and destroy that face of card, it's pretty good. Next is the one Foxy, it's Pot of Blood, the effect. If you don't know what Pot of Blood does, is to draw 3 cards, not exactly to draw, just look at them and to choose one of them. So Foxy is really good too, because of its effect also, but its effect is actually only for Solomon Great, so you have 3 Solomon Greats, you choose only one of them and the others must shuffle into the deck. So that's a little minus, but still it's pretty good. And next is the one Spinny. Spinny is pretty handy. Well, especially on itself from the graveyard and to by discarding itself all Solomon Great monsters in the field gain 500 attack. That's really, really, really good. I really like it. And so that's how for the level 3. So for the level 2 and level 1, that are the last, are playing the 1 minion. This card over here is broken. Just broken. This card must be limited. I know this is kind of silly for Neo, but still this card is really good, and that's why it must be limited. Especially itself from by when this card is actually hand except by the regular draw, special summon it itself. So that's why it's so good. And next is Raccoon, because it's, well, life point gain effect. So let's say we have 8,000 with that. So yeah, let's make, you know, well, this what to make him, and that is Mo. The last is Mo. He's one of the best level 1 Cybers monsters, and well, whenever you leave some of the summon great monster, especially self from your hand, to a zone, this monster points to. And also, if you have no cards in your starting field, you can shuffle 5 summon great cards from your graveyard to the deck, and then draw 2 cards. So, shuffling ability. There are basically 5 cards, 5, and all 3 effect. I'm also playing it because, well, must play it. And that's it for the summon great monsters, and for the non-summon greats, yeah, I'm playing a lot. I think there are more than spells and traps, doesn't matter. So this deck is 45 cards. And the first one is the level 11 Endure the Primal Being. And you know, it's the fact, so when your opponent summons any type of summoning, Pendulum, Sneakerixies, or anything, any summon, you can just destroy them and give up your opponent a token that has attack points equal to every one of them's attack. So, the total attack into one token, and you special summon this card. It has, well, not a lot of points, but still it's very good. And that's for you. And I'm playing also the one Tricky Iron as an adventure. It's easy to summon out because, well, they all fire on tribute, and you can just discard 2 cards. Well, they must be monsters, and then special summon him. That's good. And that's why I'm playing it, and because it's back pretty good, 2900 net point, low 9 monster, pretty good. I really like it, and it's not my 8th monster. And next is Burgeer, because it's really broken effect, and you can just discard 1 card, and you can make a second attack, but it must be. But this effect must be activated only when you attack a monster in the main monster zone. It's a little minus, so you can attack monsters that are in the active monster zone. That's not cool at all. But still, it's pretty handy. You want to defeat your opponent easy. And it's not once per turn. Not once per turn. It's until your opponent has monsters. Monsters. And next is Night of Fox. It's easy to summon out from the graveyard. And you have 2 monsters to special summon itself. There are tokens, there are fox tokens, and they don't have quite a lot of attack. But still, you can trigger them to special summon for the greater Knight of Fox that has quite a lot of attack points. It's pretty good, I really like it. And it's not my best monster. Well, the best monster, it's from the activator, so yeah.